Let's specify the cross-sectional area of the truss members. And if I go back to the pre-analysis slide, I see the cross-sectional area is 0.81 centimeters squared. So let me go back to design modeler. And if I highlight line body, I see I have not assigned a cross-section. So I need to create a cross-section and then assign it to this line body. Let's create the cross-section. Concept, cross-section, rectangular. We have, you know, in the problem specification doesn't say what the shape of the cross-section is. And in a mathematical model, only the area matters. So let's make sure that we have the right cross-sectional area. So if I say a square cross-section with 0.9 centimeters each side of the cross-section, that should give me the right area. And I can see that over here, okay? So that's a cross-sectional area. And I want to, and that's what I'm interested in. So let me explain that. So I have the right cross-sectional area here. Now these things affect bending, okay? And what ANSYS will do is it'll add potential energy due to bending. So if you looked only at potential energy due to axial extension, but ANSYS will add the potential energy due to bending to that. And so it takes bending effects into account. And so the moment of inertia is important there. But that's going to be a lower order effect. So these are not going to have a big effect on your results. More on, you know, the bending effect in the ANSYS mathematical model later. Okay. And then once I create the cross section, I need to go and assign it, which is easy to forget. And so I've assigned it. And so now I have the midlines and I have the cross sectional area, both of which appear in the mathematical model. So let me save it, save the project. Let's say file save project. And then I can exit design modeler.